हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू अनदर लेक्चर ऑफ केमिकल प्रोसेस डिजाइन एंड सिमुलेशंस कोर्स कोर्स CHE446। एंड यू नो देर आर फोर सीएलओज ऑफ दिस कोर्स। सीएलओ नंबर वन इज रिलेटेड टू द फंडामेंटल्स, सीएलओ नंबर टू इज रिलेटेड टू द सिमुलेशन, नंबर थ्री इज रिलेटेड टू द एनालिसिस, एंड नंबर फोर इज रिलेटेड टू द डिजाइन ऑफ वेरियस इक्विपमेंट्स। सो इन अवर लेक्चर नंबर 23 वी विल बी मूविंग टूवर्ड्स द पिंच एनालिसिस and our upcoming lectures will be on the pinch analysis. So in this lecture, we will first define the pinch analysis, the applicability of pinch analysis, the key concepts, the historic development and industrial experience, that whether this pinch analysis has some historically and industrial background or not, why does pinch analysis work, concept of process synthesis and hierarchy of energy reduction. So, the pinch analysis, why it is used, what is the definition of pinch analysis? Pinch analysis is a methodology using which we can minimize the energy consumption of a chemical plant or a process by calculating thermodynamically feasible energy targets or minimum energy consumption and achieving them by optimizing heat recovery system, energy supply methods and process operating conditions. Basically, this is a technique in which we optimize the system, we increase the efficiency of the system. How we can increase is obviously in a process, we require the utilities like heating utilities, we require steam, furnace oil and different heating utilities, and same for cooling utilities like we require cooling water, air and so on. So basically, if we reduce the utility requirements, this is one step of increasing the efficiency, or you can say decreasing the cost, minimizing the energy consumption. Or if we can heat integrate, for example, for a distillation column, you need a heating utility in reboiler and a cooling utility in condenser. But if somehow we can integrate a column with a source which provides the cooling utility or partial cooling utility or provides a partial heating utility, then what happens? The steam requirement will decrease, the water requirement will decrease. How we can do it? Like we can preheat the feed to decrease the utility's requirement. So there are different methods by which we can optimize the system. Likewise, we can decrease the energy consumption. And how we can do it? By some energy targets which are feasible energy targets. Obviously, we have to talk about some practical targets, not in practical targets. It is also known as the process integration, heat integration, energy integration, or pinch technology. In other words, it could be said that maximizing process to process heat recovery and reducing the external utilities. What are external utilities? Again, I have told you steam, cooling water, and so on. For example, if there is a process A which is releasing energy and it is going to the atmosphere and wasting, and for process B you require energy, what you can do? You can integrate both process A and process B to minimize the energy consumption, which is the external utility consumption, and you can optimize the whole system. It is a systematic method which help engineers optimize the system and optimize the energy usage of process plants. What it involves? Analyze the heat flows. First thing you need to do that you have to analyze the current heat requirement of the system. Then you have to develop the energy targets, that how much reduction you require, percentage of reduction. We will see in upcoming slides that we require some percentage recovery of the system or percentage reduction in the cost of the system. Then identify the inefficiencies. Obviously, you need to identify where the heat is leaking. For example, if in case of boiler, you need to identify the part where there is a maximum heat loss. Obviously, if you install the insulation at that part, obviously you can save energy and again define process improvements. So first thing, analysis of the system, then setting some target, then identifying the inefficiencies, and then suggesting the process improvements. Now, if you look at these two systems, first you look at this system, which is the number one, feed is going to number three, which is the heat exchanger. Then this exchanger where utility is required, which is steam, mixing with the here, going to one, again steam requirement, going to reactor, coming back here, exchanging heat, going here, and this loop goes, then cooling water requirement, and then so this is the overall loop. And for this system, you can see that the total heat required summation of H is 1722 kilowatt, while summation of C is 654, and there are 6 units required for this process. As you can see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So 6 units, total heating and utility requirement is 1722, total cooling requirement is 654 kilowatt. Now, if you look at this improved system, first you have identified or analyzed the heat flows. Now, your task is, for example, you have to decrease the utility requirement by 10%. Then you will see that what type of improvements you can get and how by identifying the inefficiencies. So, once you have shifted to this system, I will brief it like this, that the heat requirement or the heating utility requirement have decreased to 1068 kilowatt from 1722 kilowatt, and there is no cooling requirement. Means cooling water flow rate is zero in this system. There is no requirement of cooling water in this improved system. And now, instead of two heat exchangers for steam, there is only one exchanger for the steam. And as you can see, there are now 4 units. So you have saved 2 units. You have saved heating utility. You have completely eliminated the cooling utility requirement. So that is how pinch analysis works, that it has optimized the system. How? By analyzing the heat flow, setting the energy targets, identifying the inefficiencies, and doing the process optimization. Earlier, for the feed, heating utility was used. But now, by improving the process-to-process heat recovery, the system is improved. So you can pause it over here, look at the system, and you will understand that how it is happening. Results like this made pinch analysis a hot topic after it was introduced. Benefits were found from improving the integration of process, often developing simpler, more elegant heat recovery networks without requiring advanced operation technology. Remember, there are always 2 engineering problems in chemical process. First one is related to the design of a single equipment and then designing the whole system. Now, we have been continuously talking about the targets. What are the targets? Basically, the target for energy reduction, that how much reduction we require. Typically, in a chemical process, increase in energy consumption of 10% per year is demanded. And that is quite achievable in a badly designed plant and badly operated plant. If a plant has more heat losses and it is quite inefficient, then you can achieve 10%, even more than 10% over there. But if a plant is designed perfectly, or you can say it's a good design, and it has been operated in a good way, then this target is quite hard to achieve. Typically, a reduction in plant energy consumption of 10% per year is demanded. However, like productivity targets, this is an arbitrary figure. It could increase and it could decrease, but there is some value which is available in the literature of 10%. A 10% reduction may be very easy on badly designed and operated plant where there are many opportunities for energy saving, and a much higher target reduction, which is 10%, even you can go to 20% and so on, which one is feasible in that scenario. However, on a good plant where continuous improvement has taken place over the years, a further 10% may be impossible to achieve. Again, this is the same information which is given in our previous slide where we have studied the 2 systems where the heating requirement was decreased and cooling requirement was completely zero. Targets obtained by pinch analysis are different. They are absolutely thermodynamic targets. Obviously, it should be thermodynamically feasible. How? That for if you are talking about a heat exchanger, there should not be a temperature cross. This shows the feasibility. If there is a temperature cross, that heat exchanger, you cannot install that heat exchanger. The size requirement, and there are different things involved in it. Now, what is the historic development and industrial experience? It should be in your mind, or might be in your mind, that if this pinch analysis has some industrial applicability or not, or is it just like a theoretical knowledge? No, it is not a theoretical only knowledge, but it has some industrial background. Around 90s, ICI plant thought of expanding their infrastructure, and for this you can write this paragraph meanwhile, that at the time ICI faced a challenge on the crude distillation unit of an oil refinery. They wanted an expansion of 20%, but however, For this expansion of 20%, they required a furnace. When they examined their facility, there was no room or no space for installing that furnace. It means that furnace needs to be installed not in the plant premises, but outside the plant premises. And obviously not on the same road, but opposite of the road. Means the vehicles are passing through here, the vehicles are passing through here, and one unit is installed over here, then the pipelines above goes to here. So that means a huge investment of pipelines, of infrastructure to get the 20% expansion. And not only this, but there is a safety risk. And you know very well that if a line can explode or it can corrode or some issues or insulation may break and different reasons as well. So what they need to do? Obviously, that solution was not practical. Let me read it for you, that an expansion of 20% was required, but this gave a corresponding increase in energy demand. An extra heating furnace seemed the only answer for this. But not only this was very costly, there was no room for it on the plant. And it would have to be sited on the other side of a busy main road and linked by pipe runs, an obvious operability problem and safety hazard. So what they did, they called the team of experts, which is the process integration team. And within a short time, the team had calculated the targets, showing that even in the current system, there is a slow margin of improvement, that with this, your energy requirement could have been reduced. But that within a short time, the team had calculated targets, showing that the process could use much less energy even with the expansion, that the furnace requirement was eliminated, and even within the process, you can extract the heat for your expansion. The target was lower than the current energy use. And for this, they have designed a heat exchanger network, and a million pounds per year were saved for this problem. Means, let me summarize it, that first ICI need to expand the system by 20%. For this, they required a furnace for it. They have designed that they required a furnace, but there was no space for it on the plant. They have to install it on the other side of the road. So what they did, they called the team. The team calculated the energy targets, they calculated the energy consumption of the plant, and obviously they have calculated all the steps, that analyze the heat flows, then set the energy targets, then identify the process inefficiencies and process improvement. So when they have followed all the four steps, they came to the conclusion that even there was no requirement of the furnace, and within the system, there was so much margin of improvement that you can even extract energy from process to process, and a heat exchanger network was designed over here, which was even saved million pounds per year in this system. And you can see the capital cost of new furnace with associated problems were avoided. Yes, there were new heat exchangers required, but obviously in comparison to furnace, the capital cost was definitely less, and even the process was further optimized. And the process, which was considered by the management at that time, that it's the best optimized system, that optimization was done by pinch analysis, and 30% energy savings were found in the system, and that were implemented. So you can see that without applying the pinch analysis, you are thinking that you have the optimized system running over here. And when the team of experts came, they identified that this system is not good operated. It has a potential of 30% energy saving. And if you recover the 30% energy saving, you can even get your 20% expansion within your premises. So for more information regarding the pinch analysis, you can read this book, Pinch Analysis for Energy and Carbon Footprint Reduction by IC Camp and J.S. Lim. Now, why does pinch analysis work? As I have told you, its basic purpose is to optimize. Optimization means to increase the process efficiency, to decrease the utility consumption, to decrease the capital and operational cost. Obviously, in the previous case, you have seen that you didn't require furnace, but in that case, you require heat exchanger. So obviously, the cost for heat exchanger was definitely lower than that of the furnace. So you have four streams: the initial supply temperature, final target temperature. Supply temperature means at which it is entering, target temperature at which it is leaving. So 20 to 135 degrees centigrade, and this stream is getting heat. So this is termed as a cold stream. Any stream which is getting heated during the heat exchange process is known as cold stream, and the stream which loses heat during the heat exchange process is known as the hot stream. So 170 to 60, it is hot stream. 80 to 140, cold stream. 150 to 30, hot stream. And this is the value of Cp. I will talk about the Cp in our next lecture, which is lecture number 24. These values are 2, 3, 4 and 1.5. Now, if you want to get the kilowatt, current unit is kilowatt over degree centigrade. Obviously, you need to multiply it by temperature value. And currently, you have two temperature values, outlet and inlet temperature. So, obviously, it will be calculated like outlet minus inlet multiplied by Cp. So, that is plus 230 kilowatt, that is minus 330, plus 240 and minus 180. Simple mathematical calculations. But now, you have four streams. You want to do a heat exchanger networking. One thing is for sure from this current lecture that pinch analysis is mainly used for heat exchanger networking. That heat exchanger networking was prepared in case of ICI plant. So now if you see, do you want to match these two streams or do you want to match these two streams? And what would be the energy requirement for this? For example, if you are using utility, you are basically required 470 kilowatt of heating utility, 230 plus 240, 470 to heat these two streams, and 510 kilowatt of means second and fourth, 330 and 180, 510 kilowatt of cooling utility. But how you can decrease the cooling and heating utility requirement? Can you do this like heat and trial? Obviously, you cannot do this. You have to check the thermodynamic feasibility. You have to check that there is no temperature loss. So obviously, it's not a trivial method. It's basically a proper established method which we have to use while dealing with this pinch analysis and doing the heat exchanger networking. So that is also again the same. And one thing is that there the interchangers means may have not a temperature difference between hot and cold stream. This is the delta T minimum, which is usually your energy target, that the minimum temperature difference between hot and cold stream at one point should not be less than or may not be less than 10 degrees centigrade. Means if I have drawn the diagram of it or draw it, these lines graphically or problem table approach, these are basically two techniques used for it, which we will talk about in our upcoming lecture, that there are two techniques for it, problem table approach and graphical method. Then we will see that at each point in the interval, this may not be less than 10 degrees centigrade, which is your energy target, which is labeled it as delta T minimum, the temperature difference between hot streams and cold stream. But we will talk about it a bit later. An available utility steam sufficiently hot, cooling water sufficiently cold for heating and cooling utility for this system. As I told you, 470 kilowatt steam utility is requirement. 510 kilowatt cooling water utility is required. And if you want to decrease it, you cannot do it like heat and trial that connecting 230 with 330 and connecting 240 with 180 and system is solved. No, that is not the case. And this is the same point which I have already illustrated you, that it's not a trivial task. But how do you know whether it is even remotely optimal? Do you continue looking for better solution and how? So now, once the concept was introduced in the system, and as you can see, the concept was introduced, furnace requirement was eliminated and heat exchange networking was introduced. But at that time it was like, okay, so it is just about heat exchange networking, means where heat exchanger to be installed, it is just related to it, but it is not related to the other system. But pinch analysis is just about the heat exchange network, isn't it? That's a common response from people who have heard about the technique in the past. Isn't it only applicable to oil refineries and large bulk chemical plants, or maybe not to my process? That was another story at that time, because that was oil refinery plant. So maybe like in the fertilizer plant or in some other plant, people might be thinking, no, that is not applicable to my plant and that is applicable to their plant. That is definitely not the case. It could be applicable to each plant and each process. And obviously, where reactors are involved, the stream is going out of the reactor and it is getting heat exchange. So what do? You can even apply pinch analysis over there. Obviously, on the reactor, you cannot apply. But if a stream is, if you are sending a feed to the reactor, which is getting heated, and if you are getting product from the reactor, which is getting cooled, then you can apply pinch analysis on this. That instead of cooling it down with a cooling utility, you can exchange heat with the some other process in the system. But obviously, with the time, you will understand these aspects. Pinch analysis has broadened a long way beyond the original study. It is now an integral part of overall strategy for process development and often known as process synthesis and the optimization of existing plants. Now, if you look at this diagram, there are four steps involved in it. First one is the reaction, chemical synthesis. Obviously, the process starts with the reactor. Mostly in chemical industries, there first a reaction takes place, the reaction is carried out, then the separation, process development, then heat exchanger network is designed, where you have studied the heat recovery. So you can see that even in the process where reactors, distillation columns are installed, you can even apply heat exchanger networking or pinch analysis over there as well. And heat recovery and again site heated power system, utility cooling, pumps and compressor. And you can enhance the heat recovery of the system, that you can enhance the process to process heat recovery, but you can decrease the external heating requirement. So that is the overall scenario of this process synthesis, that it is hierarchical in nature. Chemical reaction step, then separation task including recycles, then various heating and cooling utilities or duties for the streams, the heat exchange network are calculated for this system. So that is overall picture of process synthesis. And the last topic of today's point is hierarchy of energy reduction. So the hierarchy goes from here to here. First, avoid or reduce, then recover heat and improve utility supply. Now, what is meant of it? Avoid or reduce the energy consumption. That is meant by optimization. That is meant by increasing the process efficiency. Recover heat from the process. Recover heat. It means that if a process A is releasing heat and if a process B requires heat, then integrate these two processes so that you can optimize the process. You can avoid the wastage of heat, you can avoid the external utilities requirement, and you can optimize the system and improving the energy supply system. And obviously, once you improve the energy supply utility system, for example, if you can run the process with steam, why you are running the process with furnace oil? Furnace oil is obviously expensive. Similarly, if you can run the process with a cheaper utility, then why to use the expensive utility? So you can reduce the cost, or you can reduce the primary energy requirement. So basically, the four steps, or even you can say it as three steps as well, avoid or reduce the energy consumption by analyzing the heat flows. Again, the first slide, if you remember, analyzing the heat flows and determining the energy targets. Then the process inefficiencies and process improvement. So these four steps are linked in our complete lecture of this session. Then recover heat and improving the utility supply. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much. In the next lecture, we will talk about the practical implementation of pinch analysis, where we will use graphical method and problem table approach to find out the utilities requirement and pinch temperatures for hot stream and cold stream. Thank you so much.